Hey S'mores, I'm Shannon Morris and today I am building my server rack. I have been around server racks for several years through my work with Hack 5, but I have never built one myself. Since my plan going into this new studio was to upgrade my network to something that was more oriented towards a small business or a prosumer, I switched the components that I got from my ISP and from my home to a new series of equipment from Ubiquity. So special thanks to Ubiquity for providing the networking products. And now it's time to build the rack for all my goodies to be installed safely in. So the rack you see me unpacking here is by NavPoint or Nave Point, and it's the 15U wall mount server data cabinet. It's a 24 inch depth with a glass door that includes a lock and casters to roll around on. The casters don't lock and the door lock is really easy to pick. I'm just gonna put that out there. It has a capacity of 130 pounds, has rails with the cage nut style bolting, and it fits any standard 19 inch rack mount equipment like my new Ubiquity Dream Machine Pro. It also includes two fans for the ceiling panel, although I currently don't have those running since my basement is so cold as it is. Yay, Denver winters. You will notice that the rack comes in pieces. And one tip from my networking friends was if you don't intend to take some time to put it together right, just hire somebody to do it for you. And after I built this rack, I can kind of see why. It's a pain in the butt. I can't imagine what it's like to work in a data center building racks that are taller than you. No wonder people just pay to have them pre-built and just rolled in. There was a bit of a learning curve for me since this was my first rack build, but now I know how to do it. So watch out, data centers, I'm coming for you. The server rack cabinet on its own costs about $360 from Amazon. I'll put the links down below in case you are interested as well. So once I started reading the directions and putting this whole thing together, I could tell this was going to be a two-person job. So I asked my husband to help with some of the annoying little bits so I could at least put together the exoskeleton of this thing, and that helped a lot. My friend Russell, who runs his own networking company, he happened to be in town, so he gave me some tips on putting it together, and he was so amazing. He brought over some extra pieces like a cable organizer, some extra cage nuts, and some rack mounted shelves for me to sit things on to give them more airflow. One thing Russell recommended was doing some considerations about where I want the rails to be installed based on how far power or networking cables would stick out from the equipment and how much room I would need in order to put the back panel on as well as the door on the front. So luckily I had my NASes and my Ubiquity goods in the studio already, so I just measured those and determined the best placement for those rails. Starting from the top allowed us to just use gravity for the rails to fall into place for us to mount them at the bottom. After we put in the rails, I tightened a few screws, moved on to the back rails using the same pro tips for placement, and then it was time to put together the door lock and put the casters on the bottom of the rack. I went with casters instead of wall mounted. I did want to point that out because I wanted a rack that was easy to upgrade or access from the front or from the back. I also wanted to be able to move it around, but keep it off the ground in case there was a flood in the basement. Now, before putting on any of the side panels, I started installing my equipment, starting from the bottom and working my way up. This gigantic brick, it's so heavy. It is the heaviest part, so I placed it on the bottom of the rack. This thing is called a Triplight 500VA Smart UPS Backup. In the event my power goes out, this heavy thing would keep my devices on long enough for me to safely power everything off or get a generator up and running. I built this in July, and so far the Triplight battery backup has not failed me yet. This thing costs $250 off Amazon, and it does come with a warranty. The battery only takes up 1U of rack space, which is good since the next part was my giant Synology NAS. This is my biggest network attached storage system. So this product is simply sitting on top of a little rack mounted ledge, a little shelf that Russell brought over for me to use. That's great since this is not a rack mounted NAS. It's a consumer grade one that you would just sit on a desk. So I still wanted to stick it in my server rack and connect it directly to all of my networking gear. Above this is another shelf for my smaller network attached storage backups, both of which are also Synology, and one of which is my Plex server. If you're interested in that, I did do a video on it previously. So we determined how much space those NASes would take up, and we decided to install the Ubiquity equipment right above that. This first big silver piece, that's my Ubiquity Dream Machine Pro, or UDM Pro, which should be able to replace my ISP's box that I use for my fiber connection. Then we place the 24-port Switch Pro right above it. This switch has enough ports for most of the rooms in my home since the house already came with Cat5e pre-installed. I also set up Cat 6 here in the studio. I did an entire video on that installation since it was DIY. So my plan was to hook up all of the Ethernet through the switch, add a few things to the UDM Pro, and tie all of this into my ISP's fiber connection. Now, right above that, Russell recommended adding a cable organizer, and I'm glad he did because that's not something I would have thought of since I've never built a rack before. So we stuck that at the very, very top, and this is going to feed all those Ethernet lines comfortably down to the 24-port switch, and it will make it look a lot cleaner from the front. It will also add a little bit more durability to those Ethernet lines because I won't be moving them around a lot. So next up was removing the current box and placing the new rack where my old internet closet was installed. This big white plastic box used to be mounted in the framing when we first moved into the house, so it was removed and set on the floor during construction, but everything remained plugged in. This box contains my ISP's box, my fiber line, a switch, and my smart home bridges from Philips Hue and Lutron Casetta. You will notice that there are two thick internet lines feeding out of the switch. They're a little bit darker of a blue color. Those are power over Ethernet or PoE lines that run up to two Wi-Fi routers, which are set up in a mesh network. One is on the main floor above the basement, and one is on the second floor, which is two floors above the basement. The PoE is run up through the walls to the ceiling where each of those routers are mounted. So with the internet unplugged, now that I'm moving that white box out of the way, I needed to start organizing the cables. So I did this pretty thoughtfully too. Before removing them, I placed them through the topmost cable organizing hole, which is built into the rack, room by room. So I started with the basement and that whole series of Ethernet lines feeding through first. We wrapped any remaining stretches of cable and stuck it next to the wall and fed a little bit extra up into the wall to keep it out of the way. That last yellow Ethernet line was going to my ISP's box for internet until I set up the Ubiquiti UDM Pro to take its place. I had a lot of fun organizing this thing. I love cable organization. It was kind of like Tetrising the rack to make the most sense. Once we got the Ubiquiti switched over via a customer support chat with my ISP because we had to do some configuration changes, I was able to take the main internet line and plug it directly into the UDM Pro. Once I tested the main networking equipment to ensure it was all working, I went ahead and installed my CyberPower surge protector in the back. Now this thing also takes up one U in the rack, but it's a lot more narrow and it has 12 outlets. Now this didn't fit everything because of how the plugs are positioned. They're sideways instead of straight up and down. So I also have a little surge protector laying in the bottom of the rack for everything else. The CyberPower surge protector was about $100 as an investment on Amazon. The brown line that you see here is the fiber to the door's power, which is plugged directly into my battery backup. Not on video is also a little ground connector, which is attached from the power cord to the chassis, and that came with the rack server cabinet. So I am pretty proud of my little server rack. I think it looks super cute and it's awesome, and I love the stickers on the side on one of the side panels. One tip from a few friends was to buy one that you think is too big, and I'm glad I did because I was gonna buy a smaller cabinet, like a 12U, and I thought 15U would be too big for my networking needs, but it ended up being perfect for the size of my space. I will be showing you how I set up my network in an upcoming video, so stay tuned for that. Until then, thanks so much again to my studio sponsors, including Ubiquiti, Lutron Casetta, Alienware, and Uplift for providing equipment for the new studio. And a huge thank you for supporting me throughout this year. I know it's been crazy, but I'm so happy to be moved into this space. It's been a really positive change. Thank you so much for subscribing and for watching my videos, and mad props to the folks who support me on Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, and right here on YouTube memberships. Check out the rest of my studio series, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you soon. Bye, y'all.